Tyka touch, full body orgasm. Call it full body orgasm because it can bring the person to the full body orgasm within 20 minutes without even touching the person. It also brings, may bring the healing.
Depends from the person,
the person being what the person is ready
for.
If the body, if the being is ready for the healing, as more we heal, then more pleasure we will feel. Most of the things without touching, but sometimes we use the triggers, slight touch of the body to bring, especially many of us are kinetic, that's why we also attracted to tantra, that we are sensual for the physical touch, and we use these touches to trigger the energy. And those triggers there are many. I will show you all of them later. And for some of the people can work this one better, and for some of the other, for some of the people, energetical touch will be more.
So
basically, there are not so many rules about the energetical touch, but there are a few things what is good to keep in mind. Basically, you follow your intuition. You don't have to think about the technique. Actually, as less you think about, but you keep on moving however it feels,
and then
it can bring into dimension where things are much better than being occupied in the mind. So we mainly work within the spine, along the spine. We work on different chakras. Could be very often, that especially for the woman, we may bring the energy up, downward. For the man, we bring the energy upward. This is not always true, but we may think what works better. Also, we can follow our intuition, and we can do also both. So, it's good that we work on chakras. Usually, the second chakra and the heart chakra, they are good to work on. Chakras, if we feel so. These are the some of the main movements that we work on chakras, and the other movements, it's like stroking the energy up and down. The other ones, when you feel that somewhere, or your intuition is telling you, somewhere you can take out the energy. Imagine that you pull the thread, you just take it away.
So,
and basically, before you start, you may ask the person to breathe without hiatus. That means hiatus is the moment between your breath in and breathe out. So, or breathe in and breathe out, or breathe out and breathe in. The small break, if you notice, if you breathe naturally, there is always a little bit break between. And if you ask the person to breathe without this break, breathe without the hiatus, then the energy flow on her breath.
Anumite gânduri care ar putea
so
să
if you can breathe in that way.
Dacă poți să respiri în acel mod.
So coming back to the strokes,
we
stroke in that way. We pull the energy. We may wipe the energy, especially from the first chakra. We can bring it. We can do the same from the crown chakra, and we can wipe the energy to that direction. Connect, synchronize with her breath. It always brings a deeper connection between you and the receiver. Dance with your body, with your pelvis. You don't only work with your hands, but you involve all your energy, like in the tantric
massage.
There are all different moves you can play with it, but I show you the most important ones. Now I will show you all different triggers, what you can use between the stroking the energetic body. So one is bringing along the spine, the shushumna, to the throat, and one or three times. And then you'll keep stroking again. And whenever you feel that some of the trigger may help, you try another trigger. You can always place your palm on the chakra, anywhere you feel. This is another trigger. You may also pull the energy. On the chakras, especially on the thymus, you may shake between the nipples. Then you can pull. And another trigger could be very slightly do the 8 around the breast. Under the knees, you circulate there. With one hand you can do the trigger, with other one you can work with energy. And basically, her body also tells you where you can pull. Then you can do also on the outer part of the knee, on both knees. And the third eye.
Ah.
upper ear,
partea de sus a urechii,
the throat itself. Second chakra,
chakra
the